For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Hundreds of Venezuelans took to Plaza Bolívar in Caracas on Sunday, October 17th, to reject the illegal extradition of Special Diplomatic Envoy Alex Saab to the United States.
Alex Naim Saab Moran is currently in the custody of the United States law enforcement in Miami after having been extradited from the Republic of Cabo Verde to face prosecution in the Southern District of Florida. On Saturday, October 16th, after 16 months fighting the United States' request for extradition from the Republic of Cabo Verde, Saab arrived in the United States. Saab had his initial court appearance today at 1 p.m. in Federal Magistrate Court in Miami before U.S. Magistrate Judge John J. O'Sullivan.
Alex Saab was extradited on October 16th after being detained in Cape Verde for 491 days following his arrest on June 12, 2020.
En nombre de mis hijos y mío, Camila Saab, quiero denunciar el día de hoy la concreción de un segundo secuestro a mi esposo Alex Saab con la complicidad del gobierno de Cabo Verde que realizó junto a los Estados Unidos el día de 17 octubre del 2021.
He was arrested at the request of the U.S. government at the Amilcar Cabral International Airport on the island of Sal. The Venezuelan government released an official statement condemning Saab's kidnapping by the U.S. with the complicity of Cape Verdean authorities. Saab, a businessman of Colombian origins, was sanctioned by the U.S. Department of Treasury in July 2019. He was alleged to have personally profited from overvalued contracts, including the government's food subsidy program, CLAP. These allegations, however, were not backed up with concrete evidence. The sanction against Saab was issued in the midst of intensified attacks against Venezuela in 2019. The U.S. had even pushed to advance a coup d'etat against the democratically elected government of Nicolas Maduro by using an opposition leader, Juan Guaido, who unilaterally declared himself president of the country on January 23, 2019. Since Saab's arrest in June 2020, Venezuela had been waging a campaign for his release and to block his extradition to the United States. His defense team brought the case to the Cape Verdean courts to appeal his illegal arrest. The Constitutional Court of Cape Verde declared the appeal for the unconstitutionality of the illegal detention of Saab inadmissible. Venezuelan authorities also denounced that during his detention, Saab suffered from torture from Cape Verdean authorities. Saab's legal team had requested Cape Verdean authorities to transport him to the capital, Praia, to receive necessary medical treatment as he suffers from multiple ailments, including cancer. Meanwhile, Venezuela's representative to the dialogue process in Mexico, Jorge Rodriguez, announced that the national government of Venezuela is suspending its participation in the dialogues. The dialogue process between Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro and the far-right opposition led by Juan Guaido could provide for a gradual lifting of the U.S. sanctions against Venezuela and its leaders. Rodriguez added that the life of Saab is in danger and held the governments of the U.S. and Cape Verde responsible for whatever happens to him. He also highlighted the multiple illegal elements of his detention, noting that Saab should enjoy diplomatic immunity as he was on official diplomatic business when he was arrested in June 2020. On March 15, 2021, the Court of Justice of the Economic Community of West African States had ordered the immediate release of Alex Saab. It also ordered a payment of $200,000 in reparation for the violation of human rights following his illegal detention since 12 June 2020 at the request of the United States. The United Nations Human Rights Committee had also called on the Cape Verdean government to halt Saab's extradition. The Venezuelan government maintains that the persecution is yet another part of the campaign of aggression from Washington against the Bolivarian Republic. Saab himself had stated that the process against him has a clear political motivation, which is to overthrow President Maduro and force Venezuela to submit.